A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In the previous class, you learned about commands. Have you all learned properly about commands? Let us now revise from yesterday's class. Do you know what is the command for copy paste? The shortcut command for copy is Ctrl plus C, and the command for paste is Ctrl plus V. Can you tell why we use copy and paste? We use copy paste command in order to make more copies of any text or image. What happens with the command for cut paste? Using cut paste, you can remove a text or picture from a place where you don't want it and then paste it at a place that you want it to appear. Can you tell which command you will use for cut? You will use Ctrl plus X for cut. What is the command for undo, redo? The command for undo is Ctrl plus Z, and that for redo is Ctrl plus Y. Why do we use the rectangular selection? We use rectangular selection to select a picture because to select a picture, we need to have a rectangular box surrounding the picture. Can you tell what happens if you cut a drawing which has been made with the help of color box 1 and color box 2 using fill with color? If you cut a drawing that has been made using color box 1 and color box 2 and with the use of the fill with color option, then in the place where you cut the drawing, you get the color which you had selected for color box 2. Let us now begin today's class. Now, all of you power on your computers and open the MS Paint file. In today's class, you will use the oval tool to make a picture. The pictures that you will make will be of watermelon, teddy bear, and some more such pictures. Look at the picture being shown to you and tell what do we call this picture. This is a picture of a watermelon. How will you make this picture? To make this picture, you will use the oval tool and color box 1 and color box 2. Besides this, you can also make use of the command. Can you make this picture or not? If you face a problem in making this picture, take help from the video. Let us now watch this video and make the picture for watermelon. So, to make this picture, we first need to select the oval tool. So, bring the pointer there and left click on it to select the oval tool. Then, go to the fill option and select solid color because we will be making solid ovals. Select color 1. Let's use the green color for this. Select color 2. Also use the green color here in color 2 also. Now bring your pointer to the drawing area and drag an oval, a slightly bigger oval, which will become the outside of the watermelon. Next, make color 2 as white because we are going to cut the portion that we don't need. And you know, if you don't make the color white, then the green color gets filled in the area after cutting. Now come to the selection tool and select the rectangular selection and bring the pointer here and select the top portion of this oval that we have made. After selecting, you can use simply the cut command, the shortcut for which is Ctrl plus X, and cut the top portion. Let's change the color 1 to red, because now we are making the inside of the watermelon. Change color 2 also to red. Select the oval tool now. Remember that if you have selected some other tool and you want to use the oval tool, then you have to select the oval tool. Now make a slightly smaller oval here by dragging, which is red in color, so which will become the inside of the watermelon. Again, since we have to cut this, we will make color 2 as white. So select color 2 as white. Then come to the select option and select the rectangular selection. Again, bring the pointer near the red oval and select the top portion of this oval. After selecting, you can use the Ctrl plus X shortcut command for cut and cut the top portion of this oval. Now you need to select the bottom portion which is left. After selecting, you can just drag this and place it inside the green oval. When you try to place it, you can see that the bottom portion is getting hidden. For this, go to select option and select the transparent selection to correct this. Now you can again properly position the red oval in the green oval, and this is how your picture will start looking like. Now we have to make the seeds in the watermelon. So we go and select the oval tool again and select color 1 and color 2 both as black. So we selected color 1 as black, selected color 2 also as black, and then make small oval which will be the seed of the watermelon. So we make this. Now we need to copy paste this. So we need to go make color 2 as white, then go to the select tool and click on rectangular selection. Bring your pointer close to the black oval that we have made and drag a rectangle so that this black oval gets selected. After selecting, you can just do Ctrl plus C to copy. You won't see any change happening, but when you do Ctrl plus V on the top left side of your sheet, you can see a copy of the seed has come. You can drag this and make it positioned like this, as is being shown in the video. One more time, use Ctrl V, get another copy, and then drag this copy also inside the red portion of the watermelon. One more time, do a Ctrl plus V to get another copy. Drag this one also. So like this, you can continue by using Ctrl plus V or the paste command and then dragging the seed inside the red portion of the watermelon. Let's do one more. Ctrl plus V. The copy appears and then you drag it here. So this is how you can make this beautiful picture of a watermelon. Do you know what is this picture called? This is a picture of a teddy bear. Can you make this picture? If any of you are facing any problem in making this picture, then watch the video to take help from it. Let us now watch this video and see how we can make this picture of the teddy bear. So to make the teddy bear, let's first select color 1 and color 2, both as black, since we want to make a solid oval. Now, after selecting color 1 and color 2 as black, since we want to make an oval, select the oval tool. By taking the pointer there and using the left click on your mouse or touchpad, come to the drawing area and here drag an oval to make the stomach portion of the teddy bear. Now make color 2 as white. So that we make an oval which is black in outline but white inside. And we drag this oval to make the face portion of the teddy bear. You can adjust by moving the selection lines. Just keep your mouse, click it and then drag it towards the left or the right. And you can drag the oval itself by keeping the mouse or the touchpad button pressed, left button pressed, and then dragging. So you can position this oval to make the face as you like. Next, let's draw an oval inside the stomach area, which is white in color. And just reposition it to make it appear like you have seen in the original picture. So you can resize it by moving the selected lines of the square on top of the oval and position it like this. Once again, change color 2 to black and draw a small oval here. We are going to use this to make the hands of the teddy bear. Now we need to copy paste. So first remember to make color 2 white. Go to the select tool, select the rectangular selection option and then select this last oval that we have made. Copy it by using the shortcut Ctrl plus C command for copy, and then get a copy pasted on your sheet by using Ctrl plus V. Now move this copy by dragging it and bringing it so that it appears like the hands of the teddy bear. Since we have one already, we can select the oval that we made, the small oval that we made, and drag that one itself to make the second hand and position it here as is being shown in the video. Once again, make color 2 as black, select the oval tool, and then drag an oval here, slightly bigger now this time. Now we need to copy paste. So first remember to make color 2 white. Use Ctrl plus C for copy and Ctrl plus V for paste. Once you have the copy pasted, you can move it by dragging it to make the feet of the teddy bear. This is 1 foot or 1 foot, and we can drag the oval that we made as the second foot. So we just select it by dragging a rectangular portion and then drag it and position it here to make the second foot of the teddy bear. Next, once again, we make the color 2 as black. Now we'll be making the eyes of the teddy bear. Select the oval tool and then drag a black oval in the face area to make the eye. Like this. Let's make color 2 white. Select the oval tool once again. And then within the eye itself, we drag another small white oval. Now, since we have made one eye, we can copy paste this to make the second eye. So you can just go to the selection tool, select the rectangular selection and drag a rectangle around this eye so that it gets selected. Use shortcut command for copy, Ctrl plus C, and then Ctrl plus V for paste, and you get another copy of the eye. Drag that and position it inside the face like this to make the second eye. Now we need to make a small nose here. So once again, we will need to select color 2 as black and then drag an oval here in the face area by selecting oval tool and dragging to make the nose or the mouth of the teddy bear. Next, we have to make the ears. So we just drag another oval here . Now we need to copy paste this. So first we need to select it by selecting the rectangular selection. Remember to first make color 2 white. Then go to the select tool, select the rectangular selection, and then select this oval that we have made. Copy it with Ctrl plus C and paste with Ctrl plus V, and when you get the copy by doing the Ctrl plus V, you can just drag it to make one ear. For the other ear, we can use this oval that we had made already. So all we need to do is select this oval like this, as is being shown in the video, and then just drag it to make the second ear. So this way your picture of the teddy bear can be easily made. Look at this picture and tell what do we call it, and then also tell how you will make it. This is a picture of a cartoon. This picture has been made with the help of the rectangle tool, line tool, and the oval tool. I would like you to make this picture on your own and show it to your teacher. If you have any doubts about making this picture, then you can take help by watching the video and then make it. Let us now watch this video and take its help to draw the cartoon character. First, select the rectangular tool as is being shown in the video, and also use the solid fill option. Select color 1 and color 2, make them both the same color from the fill option. Both color 1 and color 2 we have taken as blue. Bring your pointer to the paint sheet and then drag this first rectangle to make the face of the cartoon character. Next, draw another rectangle from here, from the bottom of the first rectangle, like this, to make the body of the cartoon character. Now on one side, drag another rectangle and top of it, just drag a small rectangle here and at the bottom also just drag a small rectangle here to make one of the hands, the left hand of the cartoon. Go to color 2 option and make it white because we are going to do a copy paste. Go to select option, select the rectangular selection and then bring the pointer close to where you have drawn the hand so that we can select the entire hand. After selecting the hand, you can do a copy paste by doing Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste. Take your pointer to the rotate option and select flip horizontal. So you will see that your left hand also gets easily made. Pick the left hand and bring it to this body. You will see that part of the body is getting hidden. To correct this, go to the select option and select the transparent selection. And now you can pick the left hand and place it properly next to the body of the cartoon character. Now select the right hand, select the left hand which we had already made and pick it and place it next to the body. So both the hands have now been made. Now we have to make its leg and feet. So we go back and select the rectangular option from the shapes. Note that we have already selected solid fill from the fill option. So we go to color 1 and color 2 and make both the colors the same, which is blue. Now drag a rectangle here to make the leg and drag another rectangle here to make the right foot or one of the legs and foot. Make color 2 white and then since we have to do a copy paste again, let's go to the select option and select the rectangular selection. Select this drawing that we have just made by enclosing it by dragging a rectangle and then you can do a copy paste by Ctrl C which is copy and Ctrl V which is paste. Again you can pick this copy that you have made and place it here to make one of the legs and foot of the cartoon character. On your side, on your right side or you can say the left leg and the foot of the cartoon character. And then you can select this again, the first drawing that you had made of the leg and the foot. And now you know you have to use the rotate tool. So go to rotate tool and select on flip horizontal option so that you have the right foot of the cartoon character. You can take this, pick this and place it here to make one of the legs and foot. Now we need to make the eyes. So we need to select the oval tool. So go to the shapes option, select the oval tool. Select both color 1 and color 2 as black. Both are the same color. In the fill option, already we have selected solid fill. So we just select color 1 and color 2 as black. And then we draw a small oval here. Now we need to do a copy paste. So first thing that you have to do is make color 2 white. After doing that, come to the select option and select the rectangular selection and then by dragging a rectangle around this eye that we have made, select the eye. Now you can simply do a copy paste using Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste. Pick the copy that you have just made and place it as one of the eyes of the cartoon character. And then the first eye you can select that you had made and pick it and paste it to make the other eye of the cartoon character. So now you have both the left and the right eye of the cartoon character. Now we need to select the line tool to make the antenna on top of the cartoon character. Select color 1 as red. Also select color 2 as red, or we don't need a solid fill, so we just draw a line, a thick line. Now we need on top of it a small oval, so we go to the oval tool, select that, and now since we are going to make a solid oval, we need to make color 2 also red, so we select color 2. Make it red, and then here we drag a small oval. I'm sure you can make the lips for the cartoon character by yourself. So this is how you will make the drawing of the cartoon character. This next picture is of a house, and you should all make it on your own. Again, if any of you have a problem in making it, then watch the video to take help in making the same. So let us now take the help of this video and learn how we can make the picture of a house. For this, first select the line tool by clicking on the line tool option and then select the thickest size of the line available. So we are selecting this. You can choose the color as color 1 that you want to draw in, and then by bringing your pointer to the paint sheet, drag a line as is being shown. a slanting line. And after drawing the line, click on the side so that the dots at the end of the lines are removed. We are drawing the roof of the house first. So after having drawn these two slanting lines, just join the two endpoints so that the top of the house is ready. Now, after removing the dots on the lines, we just take a pointer here and drag a line downwards like this. Then we drag another line to make the other side of the house, or make the bottom of the house first like this, and then drag a line to make the other side of the house like this and join it to the bottom. Next, we need to make the door in the house. So once again, we take our pointer here, drag a line upwards, and then drag a line towards the right side like this. And then from the end of this line, drag it towards the bottom to make the door of the house like this. Next, we have to make the window in the house. So we bring our pointer to the place where the window should be, here, and then drag a line, horizontal line first, then draw the vertical line from the end points like this. Another line on the other side of the window, and then join the two sides of the windows to make the bottom of the window. So we just join these two from the end points like this. Now we also have to make a grill in the window. So we drag one line horizontally and some lines vertically also. So we make a vertical line in the center of the window, and we make a horizontal line like this. So the window is complete. Now we have to make a chimney on top of the roof of the house. So we take a pointer here and drag a line upwards, then drag a line towards the right side, and then from the end of this line, just join it to the roof of the house. So this way, your drawing of the house gets completed. This is how you will make this drawing. Next, all of you save your paint file and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you first revised about the previous class. Then you made some pictures using the oval tool, the rectangle tool, and the line tool. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.